Sawadee krap. I'm JP Mestanza, and it's Friday, October 25. The latest edition of Phuket News is now out. Grab your copy in any one of 600 locations around the island. Now let's start with our top story. The president of the Phuket Fishery Association is urging local residents to not panic over a beach in Naka Island off Phuket's east coast being covered with dead fish yesterday evening as if from a serious environmental incident. Phuket Fishery Association President Somyot Wong Bun Yakul told the Phuket News today that the massive dead fish are the leftovers from local fishermen sorting out their catch of anchovies, explaining that the net set off just off the beach also caught a bunch of ponyfish. He also said he has no authority of the practices of local village fishermen as this association involves the Phuket commercial fishing fleet. But he did say that he will raise the issue with the local fishery association in the area to make sure the practice does not continue. The Lang District Chief confirmed that local villagers have cleared the dead fish from the beach before they started to rot and cause harm to the local marine ecosystem. For more on this, visit thephuketnews.com. Officials are urging everyone to make sure they report any slow loris touts to authorities, and especially not to take pictures with them after one slow loris was found with many small wounds and its left paw missing. Cao Prateo non-hunting area chief Pia Wat Sukon made the announcement just before high season, urging everyone, especially tourists, not to take their picture with them, as slow lorises are a protected species in the Kingdom of Thailand, and it's illegal, as the practice helps support the illicit wildlife trade. This is the time of year when many slow loris touts start trudging out into high tourist areas to hawk slow loris photos, and he pointed out that from October 1st of last year to the end of September this year, over 10 suspects were arrested for illegal possession of a slow loris, and Caron Beach had about 80% of those arrested. The call came after rescue workers in Patong came to the aid of an injured slow loris last Thursday. The animal had many small wounds on its body, and its left paw was missing, with the bones protruding from its stump. Wildlife officers were notified and handed over to a veterinarian to receive treatment last week, with one vet saying he believed the animal was injured by an electric shock. The animal has since regained some strength, but its left stump had to be amputated further up the arm to stop an infection from spreading. The slow loris is now recovering under close watch. Local residents in Pa Klok have voted against the last stage of a four-lane ring road being paved through the area from passing through mangroves, forcing the Highways Department to redraw its plans and resubmit them for approval. The 720 million baht ring road project to expand Route 4026 through Pa Klok is meant to ease the expected traffic congestion when construction of the Phuket Light Rail finally begins next year. Initially, the plan was for the road to be elevated and pass directly through the mangroves, but due to objections from locals, an alternative route was presented which passed through a smaller part of the mangrove forest, but that too was rejected. The affected section of the road is a stretch of 140 meters that was to be elevated as it passed through a mangrove forest covering about 217 rai, according to the Phuket Highways Office. And because both the first two plans were rejected, a third route is being planned that would not pass through any mangroves or locals' houses, but it does have many more curves along the road, which means more construction. The new route is currently being reviewed for approval by officials in Bangkok and will be part of the project's environmental impact assessment, with Phuket Highways Office Chief Somwang Lohanut saying he's pushing for them to be done by April of next year. But no matter what happens, Chief Somwang says that Tepkasatri Road will be heavily affected once construction of the light rail finally begins. Phuket XTRA will be right back after this.
Join the race of legends, Laguna Phuket Triathlon Sprint Distance and Charity Fun Run. Register now, lagunaphukettri.com.
Welcome back to Phuket XTRA. Be careful when driving your vehicles with sandals after a horrible crash that saw a pickup truck run right through three motorbikes and injured five Khatsitsart University students in Bangkok, one of whom is still in an intensive care unit as of this broadcast. The incident took place yesterday and was caught on the dash cam of another vehicle, quickly circulating on social media. The truck is seen traveling at high speed and running into the oncoming lane, crashing head-on into three motorbikes with five KU students on them, one of whom is still in the ICU. The incident actually took place on Katsitsart's main campus in Bangkok's Bangkhan district, in an area that is usually open to all vehicles in an effort to ease traffic congestion in the area. But the university issued a statement earlier today saying they would strictly screen non-school vehicles entering the campus and ban them. Meanwhile, the driver of the pickup, 38-year-old Ratawit Sarawutwinai, is being charged with reckless driving, causing injuries and damage to property, admitting that he was driving around 80 kilometers per hour at the time and that he could not slam on the brakes because of a pair of sandals that had become wedged under the foot pedal. An alcohol test can't come back negative, and he's now been released on bail for fully cooperating with police. More fishy stories coming your way, this time in Chalong, as local mayor Samran Jindapon gave away 1.3 tons of fresh fish to locals in Chalong after fishermen in Wawai landed more than 2 tons of fish in a surprise haul at Naiharn Beach on Wednesday night. Mayor Samran explained that the fishermen brought in the massive haul of the hardtail scad, also known as torpedo scad, on Wednesday night in Naiharn, with dozens of people helping bring the fish ashore. He explained that although 2 tons of fish could bring in a lot of money, the massive surplus would mean the fishermen would have been paid little extra if they tried to sell the fish at a market on Thursday morning. Mayor Samran bought all of the fish at regular prices, about 100 baht for three, all to give away to local residents. The fresh fish giveaway was held at the car park in front of the Chalong municipality offices yesterday morning. And that's it for Phuket Extra, brought to you by PSD Windows and Doors. For safe, secure, and soundproof windows, visit pvcphuket.com. We'd like to get your feedback on any of the news you just watched, so drop us a line in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe. From all of us here at the Phuket News Center, thank you for watching, and until Monday, stay classy, Phuket.